channel. Appreciate you stopping in. Hope everybody's having a great Sunday. I do. I really, really do. Do I? I don't know. Well, I had a great day. Went to church because I need Jesus. And so do you. You bunch of heathens. And I went to church with my family. Had some breakfast at the whole Mom Duke's house. If you guys follow me on Instagram or Twitter or Facebook, you will see that I had an awesome breakfast. Hence, the reason why I went to the gym. This meal, too. I'm probably have to head to the gym again, too. So, but yeah, it was a good time. I went to work. I had to wait on somebody, so in the meantime, I went to the gym. But yeah, it was a good day. I like days like this on Sunday where it's chill, relax. Oh, check out this bit. I'm not gonna say the B word, okay? I know some people got on me about saying bitch. I didn't mean it like that. When I call bitches bitches, I'm calling bitches bitches, not y'all. Yo, so I go to the gym today, and I get asked the same question again. Like, hey, my friend, one of the trainers, are Colleen. She looks at me and she goes, "Are you seeing somebody?" And I'm like, "Oh God, here we go again." I talked about this shit the last video. And I'm like, "Let me guess, because I look happier." She goes, "No, you look fatter." I was like, "What the fuck? Aren't you a trainer?" Shit. But she said, "No, like, when you're in a relationship, you tend to eat more because you're happier." So she said I looked a little bit more chubby. And I was like, "No, I'm not seeing anybody. I'm actually seeing over 300 people that make me eat motherfucking Chinese food." No, I'm not going to blame y'all. I eat this because I want to eat this. Yes, I wait to make a video when it comes to more unhealthier stuff. Because that's what y'all want to see anyways. If you look at my shit, the number one video is Chinese food. I gotta do another one of them shits. Mad subs and comments and thumbs up all day. Let me stop. I don't care about that kind of stuff anyways. I don't care. I'm mad humble. Let me stop talking about that. Anyways, listen. I got some down south cooking right here. I got some pulled pork sandwiches. And you know how we do it. If you're from the south, you know how you do it. Pulled pork, hamburger bun, fucking red sauce or white sauce, whichever one you want. A little bit of hot sauce. Put the coleslaw on top. And then the bun. I also got some potato salad, some baked beans, and some good old down south cornbread. Let me show you. Golly. Smalls, just like Biggie Smalls, but it's Berto Smalls, BERTOSMALLS, Berto Smalls. Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, Vine, I'm on Vine, whatever you want to, but cornbread. But I do ask this, if you're going to hit me up in my social networks, send me a DM saying, hey, what's up, this is so-and-so from YouTube, you know, yada, 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 whatever, let me know it's you, because I talk to a lot of you guys on there, and it's hard to keep up with so many people, so let me know who you are, just, you know, I like to talk to you guys, get to know you guys a little bit better, too, because I'm a fucking weirdo. Cell phone number in the YouTube comments, please. I love y'all. You guys are the best. Don't do that. What are you doing? It's like, okay, cool. You like me. You like my personality. You think I'm funny. Awesome. You want to get to know me on a personal level. And it don't hurt that you're kind of cute. But, yo, don't put your personal number in the comments. Come on now, mama. Shout out to Ellie Rome. What up, ma? Am I talking about it? It wasn't her, by the way. Yo, when I saw that, I was like, yo, this chick, like, damn. She was crazy. Oh, shout out to my girl, Salma. What up, Salma? AKA Music Life. Shit now. She's funny as hell. I wish she would make some videos, mom. Yo, if you guys could see, yo, go check out her Instagram. I don't know if she could approve you, but check her out. Yo, she has the most, like, fuck it. She has a very kissable face. It's like so fucking cute. You just want to grab me. Or maybe it's because all her fucking pictures are like duck faces. And that usually fucking bucks the shit out of me. But she's very cute girl. And it helps the fact that she's hilarious. Send them doing shoutouts. Shout out to ASMR family. Always writing me these long ass essay comments. Golly. But she always does make a point. I definitely agree with the fact that when you are in, like, in a situation where you like somebody, they like you back, but they're far away, you're forced to get to know them. You know, you're forced to get to know them on a personal level as opposed to physical, which I get. You know, it sucks that, you know, I can't do anything else. Like, all I can do is sit there and talk to her and get to know her. But you're absolutely right. You definitely. But you know what? You know what the fuck the problem is with that? You get to know somebody, and when you start getting to know their personality, and it's a great personality, golly, you get way more attracted to that person. And I'm getting frustrated, y'all. Shit. Each other talk. Oh, you like this? Oh, you like that? Oh, my favorite color is this. Oh, your favorite outfit. Oh my god, we have so much in common. Oh my god, fuck that. I'm trying to. No, I'm saying. Can you tell yet? Yeah. And I know, I'm technically single, and I technically can go out and do whatever I want. But when you start catching those feelings, you don't want to. You just don't want to. So it's, I'm putting myself in that position. So it's my own fault. this isn't like related. Well, it's not whatever. Like the situation I'm fucking in. What do you do when you start getting to that point where you're like yo, I don't know how much I can hold out. You know what I mean? Like, what do? You just go fuck around and not say nothing to nobody. Oh, that sounds horrible, don't it? Those were big sandwiches, by the way, guys. So sorry if I don't finish this. I know it breaks your little fucking heart when I don't finish my food.